Now that takes you to Kirby Malzard, which has featured on another of my rides, the Ripon Cathedral one. Dead end, so it must be up here, the castle. Still climbing. Quite high up. So I've never been on this lane before. Hopefully it'll come out on the lane that I want it to come out on, that I have been on before. Fingers crossed. Ooh. I think it does. I think it swings round. Yes, it does. Cool. Avoided a bit of a main road section, so that's good. At a junction we take a left and we climb onto the moors. Which are quite spectacular. Here we go, left. Mm-hmm. soon we leave the farmland behind for the moorland. Later in the year, you get purple heather up here. The road sort of kinks here. We're heading for Laverton. Not Pateley Bridge on this particular ride. There's another quite demanding, very demanding ride that I've done that I will feature at some point this year, which goes up the hill that we're going to fly down later, skirting Pateley Bridge, and features some evil climbs. Right, the road's virtually straight now up to a junction with a cattle grid. It's that high up. Still climbing from here. It's really we're going to reach the moorland. Yeah. I think this is the last major climb, with any luck. I really like it over here. So peaceful. It's about 3 years ago in June I first came up here. And it was after the COVID lockdowns, but my husband had caught COVID and was stuck in bed, isolated from the rest of us. And so I made a point, because the weather was nice, of getting out on my bike a lot. And that's the first time I did this ride. And no, neither of us caught the COVID from him, which was good. But we've all had it at different times. Still climbing a little bit. There. But I shall be quite pleased when I finish this ride, because it's one of the slightly longer rides that I've been building up to, slightly more demanding, getting the muscle memory back after the winter and after being totally unmotivated over the winter too. Plus, of course, looking all over the place for care homes for mum and dealing with her. Just got the feeling when I saw her yesterday that she's given up, that she's just waiting to die, just lying on the bed, kind of waiting. It's horrible, really horrible. And it's depressing, it's heartbreaking, it's everything, it's awful. And she would not do anything, could not do anything. Oh, we're nearly at the cattle grid, I think. Yes, cattle grid's coming up, and that marks the junction where if you want to go to Pateley Bridge, you turn left, and we're turning right. Ah, moorland everywhere there, and oh, over there. Cattle grids coming up. I love it up here. And now there's a really nice downhill section. Oh yes, we have earned it, like the one on Friday. Onto the big chain ring we go. Hello sheep. Oh yes. And then we'll begin to obviously lose the moorland, and we hit agricultural land, fields and things. You can see for miles. We ignore all the junctions left and right, including the one to Laverton, and we until we reach a T junction and a give way where we turn right. We'll be turning right towards Low Grantley. Soon, or just here, is another cattle grid. So the end of the moorland. God, maybe a jump. It shouldn't have done. Here we are. Over we go. Bump, 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 bump. This is a fantastic section. It's so easy. Thank you. Oh, I think we come to the bottom of that. That is to be the ultimate downhill section. Oh my, oh my, it's beautiful. But that other ride that I was on about that goes to near Pateley Bridge does all that in reverse. So it has you hiking up that climb. That makes me happy doing that. I love sections like that. We're back to the up down bits. Oh, a bit of a climb. Right, where now? Low Grantley. We're heading for Low Grantley. It's all a bit bumpy here. This ride will take us through Ripon later on too. And Ripon is, of course, home not only to the cathedral, but the tiny little leper's hospital, which isn't a hospital in what we would think of as a hospital. It's a little chapel, and it features on the ride I did through Masson, that also goes through Ripon, where I go into a little chapel, which I'll probably do again this year. But the story is that back in the day, the Dean of Ripon Cathedral had a bit of a drink problem, and he needed money to buy booze. And so he or his cronies went along to this little chapel and they pinched the bell, which they sold to get money for him to buy his booze, fund his drinking habit. And just in case, well, he thought, hang on a minute, the chapel users, the congregation, won't notice that the bell's gone if I replace it with something that looks like a bell. But it's actually made of wood. And I'll tell you more in a minute. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. And to this day, apparently, the little chapel, its bell is still the wooden one. presumably the original bell got melted down. Wonder why I didn't go for the bells in the cathedral. It's probably easier to get the chapel bell. Probably get it with a ladder because it's quite small. I think we're coming up to, oh, soon, the T junction, maybe. Oh, that's a dead end. I think this is the T junction. What a lovely section this has been. We take a right to Grantley, and I hope that's low. And click. We are making our way back to Studley Royal Fountains Abbey. bad road surface. Crossed a little stream there, and now we're climbing. Right, so I've just changed the battery and I thought for this leg I'll try using the cheap mini microphone again and see what we get. help but think there's a climb coming up. Oh, I can see the white horse over there. The white horse that features on the Easing World Loop video. To check what we do here. won't be long before we reach Studley Royal again and head off downhill through the grounds. This time I won't take you down to the lake or up to the old stables. That's on my Studley Royal video, which you can check out on my bike ride video playlist. Whoops. And all these routes feature on my Strava page. If you want to check me out on Strava. It will take us to the lane to go on to go into Studley Royal. A sweet little lane. Crossing over so I can see what's coming round the corner and they can see me. I don't know if you can see it, but Studley Royal Church spire ahead. And that marks the beginning of an easy stretch pretty much all the way back to Bishop Monkton. Which is wonderful for cooling down, getting the lactic acid out of your muscles. Alright, gonna do what I did before. On the right, see what's coming. We go left. It's just the B road I mentioned. We don't turn there, we carry on until there's turn to Studley Royal. We'll join this road later into Ripon after going through Studley Royal. This will take us up to the obelisk, where we enter the grounds. We're approaching it from the opposite direction to the Studley Royal bike ride video I did a few weeks ago. By that I mean we're approaching the obelisk. After that it's the same all the way back to Bishop Monkton. we are at the obelisk and the gates.